And now I will have hand it over to Carmela Altamura, who will be demonstrating this with her students, a number of her students whom she will introduce, doing the works at the various tunings.
Salve. Good morning.
Buongiorno.
Wonderful diction. Very wanted. Perfect enunciation. You passed. All of you passed. Now, what I want to tell you, this was a very good idea that you saw this. I observed, first of all, let me tell you my name. My name is Carmela Altamura. I guess you probably figured out I'm Italian, right? Okay, well, as a matter of fact, I can tell you a little joke about singing. Two entrepreneurs, Italian Americans, heard that Italy is the land of song, and they wanted to make money. So we'll go to Italy. What are we going to do? We'll open a chicken farm. A chicken farm? No. You open a rooster farm. Well, why a rooster? Because he sings good morning to everybody. And then he sings in Italian. The rooster sings in Italian. Come on. Yes, he said, ki, ri, ki. Oh, that's good, she said. You think we'll make some money? Well, okay, so they went and they opened the farm, and now, as usual, the Italians sent the officer, I Carabinieri, to pass a fine. They were always looking for money. So now they found these two Americans who were as ignorant as anything about Italy. So they said, what do you give these roosters to eat? Oh, officer, Carabinieri, say, noi diamo tutto quello, whatever is on the table, and then what? Good, what? You cannot do that. Here is a fine. I'll be back in a month. And I want to ask you again, what you give to these chickens, to these roosters? The wife and the husband look at each other, so you had a better deal to come over here. So they see each other again about a month later. The Carabinieri passes again. I want to know what you give to these roosters. Oh, Signor Carabinieri, we buy the best well water, the best grain, and the best corn. You cannot give this. No wonder the rooster, only 2 miles away, they couldn't hear me. Usually it's 4 miles. The wife said to the husband said to the wife, listen, you do it the next time, since you think I'm so stupid. Okay, so there, next month, the Carabinieri passes again, and what do you give to these roosters to eat? Well, sir, here's the money. This is for you. And I give it to them to buy whatever they want. That's Italian. So now, I've got to tell you, they say that when you talk about yourself, you should keep it down to 30 seconds. And that's what I will do, 30 seconds. But before I do that, I would like 10 seconds in homage to this magnificent Lee, Olden Lee, Sylvia Olden Lee, who inspired me very much and with whom I have many ideas in common. 10 seconds. She said that she is now conducting the choirs in heaven in 432. Otherwise, St. Peter would not let her in. Okay. So, I also have founded the Altamura Caruso International Voice Competition, which discovers and forwards some of the most beautiful voices. And to do that, I had to raise the bar. When I started, I chose one of Italy's legendary superstars, Giulietta Signonato. I don't know if any of you remember her. She sang a lot with Callas in the 60s and 60s. So when she came right here in this room. And I had the same finals, the finals of my first competition. Can you believe it? With this great place, I was going like that. I didn't know anything about what I was doing, but Italians, especially Sicilians, they learn fast. So the first voice that we discovered was a contralto, and we took away the age limit because she was over the 35. And you know, Signonato was also a late bloomer. She started at 35. And so when we discovered this contralto, who came in on stage for this, she had been operated. And she came in with the cane. Yes, you have to forgive me if I don't remember the words. You know, I'm 78 now, so. forget it. So, she won the competition. And Heather Myers, and that opened immediately the career, because now the agents had something to say about her, something to work with. And fortunately, she's one of the few that once in a while says thank you. Gratitude, by the way, is the least practiced virtue. Are you sure? Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Yes. But who cares? It's not for that we do this. It is for the love. It's a labor of love, right? Yes. So anyway, one of the things I want to remember now is Ars Longa, Vita Breis. I'm going to sound educated, so what do you want? Ars Longa means a long journey, and our life is for the arts, for the Mount Olympus. Our life is short. In consideration, not only that, but we travel on the highway. Forget about perfection. Let's talk about excellence. I don't care about perfection because it's a little bit arrogant. But excellence, we can all aspire to, right? Absolutely, with our children, with everything in life, we must aspire to excellence. Now, you are all better world builders, or you wouldn't be here today. You uplift peoples through the commonality of the arts, which for me is as close to religion as possible, because what is common to all? This is the sublime, divine spark that is in the heart. And all the sages, the tallest of which is Christ, he's the largest tall tree in the forest, he spoke of the heart. And singers have to learn how to sing with the heart, because they have about the pyrotechnics and technique. That's, you could do that at a circus. But to touch, to leave you different than when you came in. Not not make you feel lonely, because now you recognize yourself, Socrates, self-knowledge. That's the purpose of the high priests that stand on stage. It's not for the beautiful clothes and the applause. They should forget that right away. And their publicity, too. Don't believe on your publicity. We have an example of that, Maria Callas. The next day, excuse me, Adriana Le Couvreur says, "Io sono l'umile ancella del genio creatore." You know what that means? I am the humble servant of the almighty genius. He gives me the word. I simply share it with everyone. I am the accent of the verse. Sometimes I am fierce. Sometimes I am kind. He writes with his hand people's futures. My voice is a fragile whisper that to the new day dies. And we start the journey of learning with the new day. So let all singers and teachers, because you learn from your students. It's a true and noble saying, but a true and noble thought that if you become a teacher by your students, you'll be taught. Because each one is a world with different anatomical anatomies, differences. Think of the tree, every leaf has a different design, every drop of snow. And so we, our job is to take them on this journey of self-discovery and self-reverence. Because once they have self-reverence, society gets healed around them. You never want to see an angry woman that didn't make it. Oh, terrible. Bitter. And so it's very, very important when we teach that we, first of all, take our time. If you notice the coaches in baseball and football, how they slow down their action so that every detail can be seen. This is what's good, this is where you made a mistake. Now, this is a fast food, fast love, fast everything. Oh my God, fast communication. It's no wonder everyone is isolated and lonely, because they don't truly speak and see each other. They have to see each other. How are you? Good morning. I'm so happy to see you. That is very important. And the singers have to learn to have this discipline. I'd like to say something that I had to learn, because Neapolitans and Sicilians, they're always too much. The teachers have to cut down. And I had to slow down and live within the structure. Teachers, artists, please remember this. Live within the structure. What you take from here, give it back. And then, now we have to have a few examples so that I can show you exactly. But I repeat this for our society, this anarchy, which happens even in music. This is license. It's not order. Structure. Solfège, the word. words. Now, another thing I noticed on Cappuccini, noticed how you could understand every word. The sopranos have to learn from that. Nobody understands what the hell they said. Because they mix the overtones. And another thing is they should listen to themselves. Actually, on stage, when an artist is the real thing, they're not even there, divinity is. They just did their homework. You see, we're just being used. That is the way. That is the way. And that's for all of us. Raising children, getting married, loving the parents, teaching. That's get out of the way, let God help us. Because he's dying to say, do it this way, do it this way. But we're deaf because we hear too much junk on that stupid television. Now, I'm going to call now because boy, I can talk. I'm not supposed to talk. The doctor said to me, don't talk, he put me on vacation. Can you imagine? I'm not talking. But I love all of you. I wish I could see each one of you, but I will. As of today, I'm going to take you all in my heart. And I promise you that I will pray for all of you that your path may be smooth and your life.